What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Today we're doing something very special for this homeowner right here. Before I get to that, let me tell you where we're at. We're at the incorporated village of Hewlett Neck, which is part of the five towns, in the southwestern corner of Nassau County on Long Island in the great state of New York. A miniature sea of condensers. We have one 5-ton unit. We have two 5-ton unit. We have three 5-ton unit. We have four 5-ton unit. Hold on, it gets even better. Yep, we have five 5-ton units. Five, Daniel. Daniel, how many square feet you think this mansion is? Just say a lot.
43.
43?
I have no clue.
Oh, come on. You're not even nowhere near close. 4,300. My house is like 4,000 square feet.
Is it really?
Yes. Sad part is these two right here aren't being used for their full potential. You may be asking, why not, Mikey Pipes? Well, the answer is very simple. But before I get to that, I want to showcase these two Bosch IDS 2.0 condensers. Not only are they amazing, amazing machines, you know, with the finest European engineering brought by Bosch, they're sitting on these awesome pads right here. You see these pads right here? These are called the heat pump pads by DiversaTech, right? Guys, if you're installing heat pumps, if you're not using these heat pump pads by DiversaTech, man, let me tell you something. You're wasting time, you're wasting money, and you know what? I'm sure your job looks nice, but it can look even better. Let me tell you something. You can save materials versus buying garages separately from the pad, which means you're going to save time on installation time, labor. They include these cool little anti-vibration pads. Look at that. See that? They're right there. They include these anti-vibration pads. And it really looks like a professional install. It really, really does, right? And they're available two sizes. We have 32 by 32 and 36 by 36. And let me tell you something. You're not just limited to using them for heat pumps. You can use them for other units to keep them off of landscaping, debris, etc. Listen, build value with your install when you install something like this, because the customer will appreciate the value and it really looks like a professional install. Check them out. Ask your wholesaler distributor about the DiversaTech heat pump riser pads for your condensers. The reason why these units aren't being utilized to their fullest potential is because we only have two wires going outside to the outdoor condensing units for those two Bosches. That's not subject to change in the near future. No plans on running a new wire with an electrician, but it is what it is. So today we are going to take out this Weather King ream 5-ton R22 condensing unit, along with probably all the lines that you see there, the indoor air handler, the blower, which directly above that is the hydro coil for forced air heating, forced hot water heating. I'm going to take this out and put in the Bosch IDS 2.0. This air handler is the one that's coming out. By the way, my 501c3 charity, Mikey Pipes Philanthropy, if you want to donate it to that charity, this is the QR code. Scan that in with your phone. My charity provides free and or low cost plumbing, heating, cooling services to those in the community who can't afford to hire a professional. We do service calls for free for people who can't afford to fix things in their home. All right, so we're going to close these two. Right, we're going to find the circuit breaker panel. I want you to get a Phillips screwdriver, which is right here, the Weeha. Let's take off that screw and hopefully we'll carefully remove that switch cover. All right, so there is the wires, and as you can see, we have voltage there. We're using our Fluke non-contact tester. I'm going to go find the breaker for it. All right, 14 and 16. All right, so we're at 50 PSI remaining on the recovery process. We removed the blower motor. I disconnected the low voltage wiring. To make my life easy and not deal with this nonsense right now, I took a grinder and I cut there and there, and I got all my wires out. And we're going to slide that in right there. And we're using an open air return because, as you can see, everywhere in this house, we have these linear diffusers that just suck in air. So we'll put one there. All right, Our second base is installed, our second unit is installed to help us. We used our noggin, we took out the blower motor. This wire is the thermistor, the coil thermistor. So we're in. All right, so I've been working on the electrical, the line voltage, and the low voltage. Daniel has got a tank of nitrogen here, and we have this contraption on the 7/8, and I'm gonna put it on the 3/8. And this is called the pipe wiper. This is the original pipe wiper. See? Pipe wiper. Refrigerant line cleaning system. And we use these little piggies, right? Foam pigs. This is for 3/8. And they give a whole bunch of them there as well. You can get this at True Tech Tools. And what this does, it hooks up to the piping. And we shoot nitrogen with a pig inside here. And it comes out the other end. All right, here we go. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and that's how you do it. You clean all of those R22 oils out of the lines. You flush out the lines. That's why it's called a pipe wiper. Pretty amazing. You don't got to use that X11 or X13 flush, whatever that nonsense is. Do that a few times, and if you want, you know, hit it with some high-pressure nitrogen after the fact, but it's not necessary. Do that 3 to 4 times, which is what we do here, and you get all of those oils out of the line set, the inside coating of the line set, and it's gone. And works like butter, baby. Works like butter. You can pick those up at True Tech Tools. If you're going to buy it, use another HVAC YouTuber's promo code, Know-It-All, and you'll save, I think, 7%. I don't have a promo code, but use Know-It-All, and let's give him some credit. All right, so Daniel's preparing the pipe wiper for the 3/8. I'm going to use my deburring tool, and we're going to try to deburr the inside of that 3/8 pipe. All right, here we go. So you take out the, I guess, bottom cap, you put the piggy in there, right? Just like that, and load them in. It's really nice. So I extended my low voltage connections from the control, kept them the same color to over here. I have my thermostat, I have my condenser, and I have my boiler. And that's all being controlled by that relay right there. So when the relay kicks on, it should turn on the fan. My fan is on. And hopefully we'll have some hot water circulating to this fan coil. I removed this wiring harness from the control board. This is all for the heat pump. You know, it's my Y1, Y2, DH, and B. You know, for the reversing valve, but we're not using that heat pump functionality on the system, so we're gonna put it right there, off to the side, it's out of the way. Otherwise, you have to cap and seal the unused wire. So let's put it off to the side, we're good. Yeah, you haven't seen Dan using a brazing rig in a while. Yes. Yes, Daniel's flowing nitrogen through the system while he's brazing. Thought you were gonna catch us, didn't you? Now smash that thumbs up button if I caught you. In case you're wondering, ladies and gentlemen, on the left-hand side, covering up most of the service valve, we're using wet rag. Daniel's now trying to attempt brazing the 3/8 onto the king valve. You see, Wet Rag by Refrigeration Technologies. It's their heat blocking putty. This little container is 12 ounces. It's not that expensive. Look, that's how you use it. And realistically, this stuff is amazing. Check them out, Refrigeration Technologies, Wet Rag. Not a sponsor of the channel, but they did send me some free gifts last year and I want to give them some love. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we just finished lunch. We went to Gotta Get a Bagel there on Broadway in Woodmere. I got tuna salaries on bagels and 3 drinks, and take a wild guess how much that was. 3 bagels, 1, 2, 3, right? With celery tuna salad on them. Mine, I had lettuce, tomato, and mayo on it, right? There's no extra charge for that. And I got a bottle of water. We got a bottle, a 20 ounce bottle of Canada Dry ginger ale, and I got a Sunkist. So take a wild guess how much that was. And I want you to guess in the description box down below. the closest without going over, I am going to send a free pipe doctor hat to, regardless of where you live in the world. I'm even going to pick up postage on that. Now, Daniel has the field piece vacuum pump. This is the VP something seven, right? 7 CFM field piece vacuum pump. We're using the by Eco Tools, the straighter core removal tool, right? I love Eco Tools. They're awesome, by the way. And I'm using the evacuation kit by Eco Tools. This is the True Blue Plus evacuation kit. We have those big giant vacuum hoses, man. Let me tell you something. You put these on there, you want to get down to 100, maybe even 50 microns. Well, 50 is kind of pushing it, but you want to get down there with the microns, you got to use this. You use those Schrader core tool removal tool, take those Schrader cores out, those valves, right, and pump this bad boy down. Oh man, she's gonna be pumping low. So a lot of you asked questions like, well, Mikey Pipes, if it wasn't leaking and you did all these steps and obviously the other contractor who didn't get the job messed up, why'd you add the sealant? Well, the answer is very simple. Very, very simple. The answer is it's an insurance policy, right? Daniel's confident that the system is leaking. I'm confident in the tools that I use to prove system tightness and no moisture in a system. That's facts, right? We're using, you know, utilize technology, right? Utilize the tools to help you do your job faster. And Craig, I'm talking to you from Precision Heating and Cooling in Plum, Pennsylvania. You know, we put in that IDS, well, you put in that IDS 2.0 system on the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy YouTube channel, right, for that family. You weren't using this. You were using your digital manifold by Testo, the 557. It took you forever, right? I made a comment, but hopefully now, Craig, is it Justin or Craig? No, it's Justin. Justin's the boss. I'm sorry. Justin, use the right tools. It'll just help you get the day over a little bit faster and get home to your families. All right. Daniel's hooking up the Micron gauge. And we're putting it on the low side. I don't think it makes a difference if it's high or low. Do you think it makes a difference?
I would say yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
This is bigger, so it's going to get
gotcha.
More.
Gotcha. So we're going to hook this up, apply power, and let's see. It is 12:32, almost 12:33. All right, so while Daniel is working on the vacuum process of this Bosch 5-ton, right? Okay, let's see. Yep, that's not 2,000. That's 236, 235, 234 microns. That's how we roll, ladies and gentlemen. And it's only been about 10 minutes. I want to thank you again. Thank you so much for tuning in to today's video. I hope I showed you a few things like the pipe wiper. Stress the importance of just doing a quality job and doing a professional job when you're installing customers' AC equipment, HVAC equipment. Listen, that DiversaTech heat pump high-rise pad really, really makes the job look amazing. Pipe wiper, saving time. You don't have to use any chemicals. Just a little bit of nitrogen, the pipe wiper. You can get that at True Tech Tools. The heat pump pad, you can get that from your local wholesaler distributor. Just make sure you get the DiversaTech one because there are some knockoffs out there and they're just not the same. And if anything, you got any questions, email me, Mike at MikeyPipes.com. And of course, as always, thoughts, feedback, and even criticism down in the comments section down below. All right, it's almost 1 o'clock. Looks like it's about to rain. Over there, no, but over here, yes. It's getting darker. So I'm out. Smash that thumbs up button and consider subscribing. There's no cost or obligation. And maybe next time, lunch will be on me. Thanks for watching.